What to do about the flu. So many of us are hearing more and more about people around us, people that we know, getting sick with the cold, the flu, all these different viruses and illnesses showing up. Definitely something serious to think about, prepare for, and watch over. But today I just wanted to give a quick natural remedy that possibly can help prevent or just help the symptoms of getting a cold or a flu during this season. The one thing that I see is whenever we start to feel a little bit sick or have a cold or get towards the potential case of having a flu, so many of us just wait. They have a couple of symptoms, they wait until it just gets much worse before doing anything about it. That's the wrong thing to do. And especially if you start having severe symptoms, nutrition is very complicated, and people who have corrupted immune systems can get very, very sick from the cold and the flu. And so go see your doctor, talk to a professional, do all those things you need to do. Again, people wait too long in general, and depending on the season, really, we should be adopting different ways of eating, cooking, and taking certain supplements, again, based on the season. It's no different when we're talking about the quote-unquote flu season. Now, it is proven, and we know that antibiotics suppress our immune system's ability to fight back against sickness and viruses. I'm not here to talk about antibiotics or flu shots, but that's just a proven fact. And so we need to be able to consume things that will hopefully help our immune system's ability to continue to fight disease, whether or not you've gone out and gotten antibiotics from a doctor. So that being said, the first thing is, and carnivores don't get upset at me, but the first thing we need to do is stop eating meat and dairy. Anytime we start feeling any sorts of signs of sickness, stop eating meat and dairy. And there are some exceptions with things like bone broth that can still bring great value. But for the most part, in general, meat and dairy cause inflammation and mucus. And although they have great benefits, during these phases of sickness, they do more harm than good oftentimes. So stick to plants so that you can recover the quickest. Second thing is wash your hands. I'm not going to spend a lot of time here. If you don't know why this is needed, you're probably a part of the problem, sorry to say. So just do it, and if you can, use natural soaps that don't kill your body's ability to fight germs. Essential oils are a good way to do that. Third, of course, you hear it every time, lots of water and lots of rest is key, especially those of you who are having cold or flu-like symptoms, or even know for sure they have the flu. Do not go to work. I see this all the time, and honestly, it still upsets me. You're making it worse for yourself and everyone around you. I know some people don't have the luxury of taking time off. They need to make their money, but you know, do whatever you can to not go out, because you're weakening your ability to recover, and you're also possibly getting others sick. Finally, the reason I kind of wanted to make this video was try this drink, and it may prevent illness or reduce the symptoms and the time spent being sick. And so try juicing a bulb of garlic, some ginger, some turmeric, and 3 or 4 whole lemons every day for at least a week or two. Take it like a shot, because it's not gonna taste great, but we know that garlic contains allicin, which when it's crushed or chewed, it turns into allicin. And that contains sulfur, by the way, which gives us that distinctive smell and taste that garlic comes with. And if you're gonna, whether you're gonna eat it or juice it, try to crush the garlic first and let it sit for like 10 minutes, because that helps activate all of the enzymes. If you are just eating it, go ahead and add honey or olive oil. Put it on a piece of bread or a cracker. Helps with the taste very much. And if you're gonna use olive oil, always, always needs to be unrefined, unfiltered, extra virgin, and cold pressed. Bragg is a great brand for this, BRAGG. Ginger, as we know, is anti-inflammatory, antibacterial. Turmeric contains the main compound curcumin, which is an anti-inflammatory and is also an antioxidant. And this really just helps reduce the severity of the cold symptoms whenever we're already having that. Lemon is vitamin C, and one of the most underrated weapons against cold and flu season. There are some great studies that show groups of people who supplemented heavy doses of vitamin C having far less cold and flu symptoms and diagnosis than groups who did not. And so vitamin C really helps boost your immune system so it can be strong and fight well. Last but not least, this is separately from kind of that juice recipe that I just provided, colloidal silver. Colloidal silver helps to disable the enzyme system of bacteria, fungi, and viruses, while also not doing any harm to the body. So if you guys want to do any research into colloidal silver, it's definitely a great product out there to use. Quality does matter, so make sure you're finding it from a great source. If you have any questions as to where you can find any of these ingredients, most of them in your local grocery store, but please feel free to reach out to me and let me know how you like it, how you don't like it, and that's all I got. Have a nice day.